for sheep, covering.
The arts of the etheria.
The etheria.
It's the only representation that I know of, which doesn't mean that it's the only one there is, where in the first stage of the Osiris cycle, where he's imprisoned, he's put in, you know, nailed into his coffin by Set and set afloat, and he ends up in Byblos in Lebanon inside his coffin, and a tree, it grows up inside a big huge tree, and here he is inside his coffin, and there's the tree around him. So that illustrates, it's an illustration of that particular episode within the cycle.
So that was some commentary by John Anthony West in Egypt. And just looking through Osiris and Egyptian mythology, you have the evil Set tricked Osiris, inducing him to lie in a magnificent coffin as part of a game, and murdered him. Set cut the body into pieces and threw the coffin into the Nile. Now, the coffin becomes a boat. It travelled down the Nile and across to the Phoenician coast, where it was deposited at the foot of a tamarisk tree. So it now becomes part of a tree. You can see this with the symbology within Masonic tracing boards. As the tree grew, it enclosed Osiris and the coffin within its trunk. The tree was later cut down by the king of Byblos and used as a pillar. So the tree now becomes a pillar in his palace. Isis retrieved the pillar and the body it contained to Egypt. And so within here you can see the progression from the coffin to the tree to the pillar, and all of these things you will see on Masonic tracing boards. Rightfully so, down the bottom here you have reference to the tree of life also. So further within the master monographs for the neophyte Rosicrucian, first up, regarding, you have regard for the physical body, the psychic body, which would be a bridge between the physical body and the spiritual body. And they look and they make mention of the mummified body being related to the physical body, the psychic body being the mummy-shaped coffin, and the spiritual body being the sarcophagus, the greater box, if you will. And also I would suggest, you know, with those, with the layers you can see here, it's very aura-like. And speaking of aura, the within the monographs for the Rosicrucians, they talk about how to see the aura, they talk about what the aura is, and of course this is not on the cards for the general public. And even though this would be related to in the Bible with raiments of light, and certainly within many churches you would have reference to that through the illustrations, and there's just so much in the Bible, and there's so much in India as well, over and over, and in China also, with these with the same thing kind of being depicted over and over. So within Freemasonry you have the tracing boards, and I would suggest that you have reference there to the aura in various places if you look carefully. And in this one in particular, you can really see the auric, that sort of auric shape right there on the coffin, and you can see the see-through nature of the coffin. Snow White and the Seven Dwarves comes to mind as well with the glass coffin. So I thought I'd make mention of this. In this depiction here, you can see the kind of water-like way of the kind of Masonic floor, if you want, the ritual space with etheric magnetic flow going across it as per Leadbetter. And of course, we've made mention here of the coffin forming into a tree, forming into a pillar. All the while, the participant would be in the center of this capsule of light, if you will, this morphing light body around the participant. And while we're at it, we have this depiction. It is from a Manly P. Hall book, and you can see the four participants around the what would be the mage in the center with the light body depicted around them with the mummy-shaped coffin there. And in this case, from the ajna, from the third eye chakra, you can see the kind of portal opened up with the entity kind of emerging from that portal in this case. And I've certainly talked about this enough with the cornucopias representing these portals from the human body. And of course, you can see entities merging from these portals. And I would suggest even in India, you can see this in this depiction here. When making this video, I came across an old image I had. It happens to be from artist Eileen Mayer, and she is a surrealist artist. Now, in this image, if you look closely, you can see the orb coming from the lotus there, and you can basically see that she has portrayed it, and I would suggest correctly, as the portal way. You can see the Eye of Horus there, and also you can see the further manifestations throughout the portal way that she has portrayed there. There's lots and lots of occult aspects to this drawing, and indeed to her further artwork. There are so many occult aspects that I don't know where to start. It's obelisks of light and pillars of light and entities and all the rest of it. But just to mention, I had a fellow viewer to this channel who went to France, sent me some pictures, and from those you have the cornucopia, which would basically be the similar portal, and you can see that it's within there definitely aligned to, in this case, the fixed signs of the zodiac. The positioning of the ball is unmistakable against the cornucopia, and the same with Aries as well, with the lamb also. Unmistakable that there is an alignment there with these portal ways from the zodiac. And I would certainly suspect manifestation, absolutely. But I've got the edge on everyone else, I guess, in that I've just simply been told, and also as I've looked at things over the years, it just seems to be the case. It just also seems to be the case that things are kept well secret. And as Freemason said years ago, the public would never believe it anyway. So I thought I would add this in. She also portrays Medusa from the body and the crown chakra. I've talked about Medusa and the serpents also. Well, I've shown that in my images prior. And in this case, yes, there is that notion there as well. Another aspect with her drawings is that with the earth energy sort of going across the Masonic floor, as I've already talked about in this video, as it happens, there's a bit of a portrayal in that also, with the checkered floor kind of being sucked into things. And it reminds me of this old drawing as well. So these sort of earth energies, if you will, going into these pillars and portal ways also. Now, as Leadbeater describes, though, you would have the building angels dropping pillars as well within the Masonic space. But there is the possibility that mages and people within the ritual scenario are building these pillars also, maybe kind of from the ground up, to put it in another way. But I'll leave it at that.